heals, but also doing the work of miracles this morning, Father God. And Father God, I thank you right at the name of Jesus. Amen. Everybody may be seated. Father God, we're going to bring forth God's word this morning.
Matthew 24, verse 45. Please turn there on your left and say amen. And we're going to stand up for the reading of the word once more. Amen. Amen. I feel sorry for the ones that ain't here getting this good word there this morning. Because it is good, amen? But God makes our Father God know who we need to be here.
Exactly.
Yeah. Oh, Jesus. When I see how my pastor needs to be filling up there, this ain't no joke. Amen. Everybody stand for the reading of the word. Please, Father God, we thank you right now. Matthew 24:45-51. Amen. Stand up. Even children, you're going to learn. Stand up, children. Stand up for the reading of the word. Thank you. Amen. Who then, the subject for the day is, are I a faithful servant? Amen.
Amen.
Who then is the faithful and the wise servant? Who the master has put in charge of the servants in his household to give them food at the proper time? It would be good for that servant who master finds him doing so when he returns, I tell you the truth, he will put him in charge of all his possessions. But suppose that servant is wicked and said to himself, my master is staying away a long time. And he that begins to beat his fellow servants and eat and drink with drunkards, the master of that servant will come on that day when he does not expect him at him. And at that hour, he is not aware of. He will cut him into pieces and assign him a place with the hypocrites where there will be weeping and gnashing of the teeth. Amen. Still remain standing because we're going to go over now to 25. Just follow me. 25, Matthew 14-30. Again, it would be like a man going on a journey who called his servants and entrusted his property to them. To one he gave 5 talents of money, to another 2 talents, and to another 1 talent, each according to his ability. Then he went on his journey. The man who had received the 5 talents went at once and put his money to work and gained 5 more. So also the one with the 2 talents gained 2 more. But the man who had received the 1 talent went off, dug a hole in the ground, and hid his master's money. After a long time, the master of those servants returned and settled accounts with them. The man who had received the 5 talents brought the other 5. Master, he said, you entrusted me with 5 talents. See, I have gained 5 more. His master replied, well done, good and faithful servant. Faithful servant, with a few things, I will put you in charge of many things. Come and share your master's happiness. The man with the 2 talents also came. Master, he said, you entrusted me with 2 talents, see? I gained 2 more. His master replied, well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful with a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Come and share your master's happiness. Then the man who had received 1 talent came and said, master, he said, I knew that you are a hard man, harvesting where you have not sown, and gathering where you have not scattered seed. So I was afraid and went out and hid your talent in the ground. See, here is what belongs to you. His master replied, you wicked, lazy servant. So you knew that I harvest where I have not sown and gather where I have not scattered seed. Well, then you should have put my money on deposit with the bankers so that I return, I would have received it back with interest. Take the talent for him and give it to the one who has the 10 talents. For everyone who will be given more, he will have the abundance. Whoever does not have, even what he has will be taken from him, and throw that worthless servant outside into the darkness where there will be weeping and gnashing of the teeth. Y'all may be seated. Amen. Look here, neighbor, and say, are you a faithful servant?
Amen. Okay. Being a faithful servant here this morning, that's what the servant is going to be about. And I'm going to put it down to you. See, people don't realize that being faithful to God is a good thing. It's supposed to be required of you. Being faithful builds integrity into your life. You understand me? Thoughtfulness for other people. Amen? Amen? I'm going to get started here. Being faithful over small things. Faithfulness is when you don't feel like doing something. Being faithful is when you, when you don't feel like doing something, do it anyway. So that's being faithful to what you do. Amen? Faithful is steadfast, given to the care of others. Being thoughtful. Amen? God is good on being faithful. He's another faithful person. He doesn't, because faithfulness, mind you, brings on other things. It brings on consistency. It brings on obedience. You start building yourself up. If you're not faithful, nothing else is going to fall behind it. Amen? Yeah. So, you have to crucify your flesh every day, as Paul says. Paul said in 2 Corinthians 12, where he asked God 3 times to remove the lust of things from his life. And God said, my grace is sufficient for you. My power is made perfect in your weakness. Amen? So y'all have to understand, even when you're weak, you're still strong. That's when you're at your best. Because that's when you're going to be faithful to go through the storm. Amen? God is good this morning. Amen. I tell you, amen. God says, y'all just give me what's going on. I know you here. Y'all bear with me. Y'all. He says, sin is like a magnet. Whatever issues you have, that sin is going to put on you. If you allow it. Put no confidence in your flesh. None. Your flesh is going to deny you at all times. Your flesh is on. See, that's why I tell flesh and babies in Christ, stay in your word, because your flesh is overpowering your faith right now. See, you haven't been through nothing yet. You think you've been through somewhere, you haven't put yourself back. Amen. God is good this morning. The Bible says, wait on him. By serving him, you got to serve others. If you got a problem, don't water in your problem. Don't feel sorry, pity party, all that about, oh, woe is me. Anybody want to hear that? God needs a strong faith for something in his army. Amen? So while you're in the midst of going through your problems, why don't you go ahead and help somebody else with their problems? And that's going to distract you from yours. Amen? And that's, you know, because God said when you take care of others, he's going to take care of you. Okay, say that. Amen? Amen. God is good this morning. Okay, amen. He said, wicked means you are lazy. What are you working for God for his kingdom? What are you working for? Ask your neighbor, what are you working for God's kingdom? Ask your neighbor, what are you working for God in his kingdom? Amen. He said, the closer you get to him, and see, this is the truth, show enough when I tell you this is the truth. When you get closer to God, you start climbing that anointing ladder and get lonely to the God. I don't know about y'all, but I've been talking to a few friends already. Amen. And I ain't even trying to. I ain't have to. They don't like me, but I ain't mad at them. Amen. Hallelujah. Okay. Faithfulness is a real commodity. Your ladder should be greater. Everything that the devil took from you, God will give you double. Know this. God shall not lie. His word does not come back void. Amen. God is a good God that we serve. Amen? But he says, y'all excuse me now, I'm going to get it together, you know. But before I go on to that part, I'm giving an example. I read Matthew 25 when they're speaking about the talents. You don't have to turn here, but I'm going to go there real quick to Luke 19. When Luke was speaking about those 3 guys with the talents, amen, one thing that Luke stated, and he's telling us the story, because that's what the gospel is, basically. Everybody telling how the story went to them. Amen? God is good this morning. But Luke says in his talk, he says in 44:19, he says differently, they will dash you to the ground. Wait a minute, hold on, praise God. Excuse me. Oh, here it is. He said, sir, they said, he already has 10. Who has more would he give? But as far as the one who has nothing, even what he has will be taken away. There is the difference in 27 than what Luke said, that Matthew didn't say. But those enemies of mine who did not want me to be king over them, bring them here and kill them in front of me. See, that's the part that Matthew forgot to tell. See, you got people that don't like authority. Amen. Do not people out there that don't like authority, don't want to be told what to do. You are three men got the same amount of money. Okay, this way the lady, when he says wicked in the in Matthew and Luke, he's not talking about wicked as an evil. He's meaning the wicked as a lazy, slothful. Amen. He says, okay, and your kid, brother, can go do what you do. What? Show me what you're faithful with, my faithful servant. That one comes back and says, look what I did, master. He's proud of what he did for his God's kingdom. But God says, hey, well done. I'm going to bless you with more. I already know you can take care of the little I already gave you. Then the second one comes. He said, well, here's what I did, master. He said, good work, faithful servant. Here you, I'm blessing you with more. Here comes the ladies, the one in the back. Don't want to be obedient to a man. Don't want to be this bestly hard-headed. Hard-headed. You got some hard-headed Negroes out there. I'm going to tell you the shame of the devil. I'm going to tell you because I'm a truth talker. And I'm going to speak to you. You understand me? You got people feel like they're all dead. Can nobody tell them nothing. That's why I'm preaching in jail right now. Still, okay, nobody tell them nothing. But somebody tell them something now. If they would allow the authority to stand something, they wouldn't be in the place where they are today. Amen. You understand where I'm coming from? Don't have to listen because they know everything. So that man, that lazy man, that wicked servant, that was not faithful to our God, he goes and he says, child, I'm just doing my part. I'm just going to paraphrase how I think it went down. Child, ain't nobody going to make that man no money, honey. He didn't have for it. You know I ain't lying. That's what he said. Because he said he got it going on. And he said, so now the master comes back and see, he didn't know when the master was going to come back. And in my head, I feel like if the master would have come back then, master wouldn't have got no $5 back because that would have been gone.
Go with it.
See, he said he didn't know when the master was returning. If master would have came back a few days later, he would have got them $5 that he paid him. That would have been gone. Y'all ain't know where they're coming from with it. Y'all gonna say something. I say I'm gonna say something.
Uh-huh.
Amen. So now the master shows up and he pops up surprised and he says to him, he says, well, what you got, Tom? What you mean what I got? I got the same thing that you gave me, bro. Huh? No respect for the learning. You understand? That's why I'm speaking the way I'm just showing you the difference. No respect. But what you been doing since I thank God when I gave you that money. Chilling? I ain't been doing nothing chilling, master. Chilling? Well, while you were chilling, you could at least, spent my money in the bank, went to the bill of interest. Man, you don't want to live for that interest, dog. You feel me?
Yeah.
Jealousy.
Yes.
Greed.
Yes.
Envy.
Yes.
Don't like to follow story.
Yes.
And how I think that the Lord spoke down to me. Amen. So how you are faithful to them? So God says, bring those ones that don't want to be obedient to me.
Exactly.
And kill them in front of me.
That's right. That's it. That's it.
Kill them.
That's it.
They're bragging to me.
Uh-huh.
I don't need them. They're faithful servants to me.
Yes.
My God.
That's it.
You are faithful servants. Amen. So I said, Lord, look here, I know I'm a faithful servant, because I want to be down, cut up in front of you and thrown to the lions.
Right.
I don't want to be one of those people, amen,
uh-huh.
At all. So in Exodus 19:4, God did not deliver the children out of Israel, out of Egypt, so that they could enjoy the promised land, amen. He freed them from their bondage so that they could come to know and worship God.
That's it.
Amen. 3 months after they left Egypt, God reminded his people why he had delivered them on eagle wings. Amen. Flying. Eagle wings. You know, they're strong wings. They soar. Amen. Because eagle wings, amen, God makes us all eagles. He didn't make no ducks. Ain't nobody
mind that
quiet.
Amen.
Ask your neighbor, which one is eagle or duck? Because I'm an eagle, I'm so high.
All right.
Amen.
That's it.
Because you got to be the only God. See, when you're eagles are strong creatures, strong birds. Yeah. Amen. He said, sometimes when you step into a place and you meet somebody, say, you might be the only God that someone
Don't represent the king.
That's it.
You have to be the only God that somebody knows.
That's it.
Amen. The seed you sow in their life might be their breakthrough.
Might be.
Amen. That's why I tell people. See, that's why I'm bringing back the story where it comes about the word tip, T-I-P-S, tips. When people go to a restaurant, and they're hungry, I'm going to bring it down to you. You go to a restaurant and you eat, and the waitress wasn't quick enough for you. Or she didn't hear you calling, but you swore to God she heard your voice saying, come out! Okay? So now, the $5 you were going to give them, don't pull it down. Uh-huh. Now, be honest, y'all, but I don't get it. I ain't giving that girl nothing. I'm going to give her $2. I'm going to give her $2. See? You don't know what kind of day that lady had. She might have prayed, her heart might have beat it over her eyes before she came to work. You don't know if her life got cut off before she came to work. Who are you to judge her? Because of the service, y'all better understand what this stands for. This stands for, there it is.
I'm going to go ahead and play the dance.
To ensure proper service.
Uh-huh.
Now, that's it. This stands for to ensure proper service. That means, that means I should pay before I even get served. That's what it means. You're paying, pay somebody before you get served, because that's what you're paying for prompt service. Amen. You might, I'm going to give you an example. I was at the flea market one day, and I think, I don't know if I told this story, but I'm going to tell it again, because God said so. You don't never know what a person's going through. When God says you might be that only person, breakthrough, that might just be that. I was sitting there in the food court and getting my glove on, girl, and the lady came up and served me. She'll be with you in 1 minute, very pleasant lady, little lady. I said, well, take your time, sweetheart. She came over to me and she said, what would you like? And I said, what's my call? How are you doing now? And then I just, the Lord just told me, I said, how is she doing? She said, oh, I'm fine. I said, well, praise God. So she served me and I ate and everything, and as I got ready to leave, she says, ma'am, hold up, I have something to tell you. I said, what is that, ma'am? She says, do you know they have my mother on life support today? And she might not make it through, and I just want to thank you for asking me how I'm doing. See, you don't never know when you are somebody's breakthrough. Be careful what you say and how you look and how you treat people, y'all. Are you a faithful servant? Because faithful servants care and are thoughtful for other people's needs. Amen.
Amen.
He said, also, he said, God did not deliver the children out of Israel or out of Egypt so that they could enjoy the promised land. He freed them from their bondage so they could come to know and worship God. Through the fact that they left Egypt, God reminded his people why he had delivered them on either way. It was to bring the people to himself. God saved them so they could enjoy instant worship with him. See, people always say, oh, yeah, God, they was in the wilderness for days, 4 years, and all that. We might have been in there 4 years because they didn't know how to love Jesus. If they knew how to love Jesus, then they wouldn't have been there 4 years.
That's right.
40 days.
That's right.
40 minutes.
That's right.
Okay. But if they had the wrong mind, cause they were trying to do so much.
That's right.
You understand me? They didn't have to understand that. All they had to do was have a relationship with God.
That's all they had to do.
All they had to do. Then they wonder why they act there. Then we wonder sometimes why we act there, struggling, going through
that. That's
and
it.
What's wrong with you? Because you got to have that relationship.
That's it.
What does that mean? What's wrong with you? You got to have that relationship. Then you wonder why you got to have that relationship. Then you wonder why you in bondage.
Yes.
Why you toe up.
Yes.
Why you toe up.
That's it.
Now. Because you don't have that relationship. Stop trying to do everything else and start loving on Jesus.
That's it, right now.
Amen.
That's it.
Amen. The Israelites have been slaves with no freedom. See, no freedom to worship God. Now that God gave them their own land, they can worship in freedom. Now God said, now, y'all Israelites, I'm going to help y'all. Because you seem like y'all are saying you're going to get out of this mess. I'm going to go ahead and give y'all the land. So that ain't no excuses.
Exactly.
Ain't no excuses. So what we do, go
God, help them to get out of situation. Lord, worry me, Lord. I promise, God, if you get out of this situation this time, Lord, I promise I'm going to church every Sunday. Stop telling them lies.
That's it, because we already know.
I promise you, Lord. Yeah. I can say this time. God said, okay, child, I'll give you the Israelites, and he gave them land. Well, now I give you the land, children, and now you can worship me and honor me and love on me. Amen. Child, here it is. Here we go. And then the promise, which is only made to a fool. And God ain't no fool.
All right.
There it is. Good morning. Now, you know, that's the man. God is not trying to be a relationship. Here you go. He done bought you some wine or breakfast or whatever. Done gave you $100, got your weed done, got your nails pulled up. Now, that's the man that suckered you back into that relationship. That God that removed you out of.
All right, that's it. All right,
there
now.
You go. Come out. He loved me.
That's it now. Talk about it now. Talk about it.
No, he gonna be my boy.
Uh-huh.
That ain't your boy. That's gonna be a trap.
Okay.
My house on fire. Why? Because And God, none of us would be sitting here and still listening to the rest of the family, because I know what I would do, because we invest a lot of time in our treasures, and our homes is our treasure. And it's got a big piece of our hearts in there. Amen? Jesus isn't saying that's a bad thing. He's just forbidding us to not enjoy and protect the things that he blessed us. Mind you, he wants us to protect and take care of the little things he's given us. See, sometimes we might not get blessed with these things, but you ain't just given the little things that I gave you. I mean, that even comes to keep your house clean. It really does. You got some of these women out here, act like they ain't got no home training. Mad. Keep your house out of order.
That's it.
God said keep his house in order. How you gonna keep his house in order and you can't clean up your house?
That's it.
No.
That's it.
Not anyway, you ain't no dog. No, I'm speaking truth here, because
that's
it's true.
That's
some of you women right here, you clean up and ask for real.
That's it.
And tell that girl, come to my house. No. Good. Thank you, but no thank you. Hallelujah. Amen. No. He said, but I doubt we'll be listening, we'll be sitting here, like I said, listening to him, the sermon, as our house is burning. We got to go forth and go check on the things that God has blessed us with, the things he has given us. What he's talking about here, though, is the problem of living for ourselves, not being faithful to him. Amen. See, when you live for yourself, your real problem isn't love, it isn't the love of the material things. That's just a symptom. See, people fail to realize, yeah, I love it. That's just a symptom of your problem, amen? The real problem is your priorities. Amen? The things that you don't have in order. Get yourself in order. Get your things straight. If you will wake up in the morning time and say, Lord, what is your will for my life today? Ask him. Don't just go get up in the morning and go do what you want to do, because your life does not belong to you. Amen? It belongs to God. Ask God. Say, Father God, what is it you have to do today? Who is in need? What is it you need? Because I know you take care of all my problems, Lord. I know you plan it with my needs. So make me a lender now, Father. Huh? And when I tell you, how good God is, and I'm giving you a testimony right now, because it happened to me last night, and I'm going to tell you, I've got to tell you, this is how God supplies your needs. When you sit, you're sitting there and you're warm in your bed. God don't like you warming because you're saying, God, I don't trust in you. I don't believe in you, but you're a faithful servant, though. And I know I'm a faithful servant, because I wasn't even thinking about it. I was saying, Lord, I got to get my pastor some stuff for the church, you know what I'm saying? Lord, well, you're working out, Lord. You know, because I really need this money for this and that. But you're working out. I ain't had no food stamps either. But listen, I get a knock at my door last night. Then I was in the bathroom, getting a shower. They knocked me harder, so I'm coming to my door. Don't be knocking on my door like the police. For real, for real. So now, a person running down the stairs. I'm like, who is it? They come up, oh, it's me, Mama. One of my little God, adopted God children. I just came by, let me show you, the blessing of God is so good. I just came by to bring you my food stamp card. Huh? I ain't seen this girl in 2 months. I just came to bring you my food stamp card, and you go ahead and spend this. I just leave that. I said, baby, I ain't got no money to give you. I ain't don't buy stamps. She said, Mama, I don't want no money.
I said, praise God. Hallelujah. I heard went to Walmart when they cut it off. Amen?
But that's just a blessing. If you wait on God, he will give you things. Amen? He said, because we will come to love. If you wait on him, we will come to love what he invests in. Jesus said, make sure God's kingdom and the righteousness are the focus of our lives. Be faithful in him. If God is your focus and your only focus, he will have your treasure. And whoever has your treasure will have your heart. But see, that one thing lies in integrity. And I'm going to read y'all a story real quick, like, amen. Not one of my books. And I'm going to tell you, it's a sad thing. It's a sad thing. But a lot of us are like this. A lot of us are like this. And we're going to call this commit to integrity. Amen. God is good this morning. Y'all feeling all right this morning? When I tell you this, and y'all going to shake y'all heads in you. Commit to excellence, which is committing to integrity. Are you a faithful servant? Ask yourself, are you a faithful servant? We're going to see today. Here's a story. I heard a story about a wealthy man whose friend was a builder. This builder was down on his luck and hadn't had much work lately. How many of us be looking for a job and can't find no job? We'll go to telemarketing, because that's the first thing I hire. Amen. So the wealthy man felt fine for him and decided to help him out. So now he has this blessing coming to him. A wealthy man doesn't know him. Helps this man out. That's down on his luck. No job, has a family to feed. Amen. He gave him a set of plans and a check for $300,000. He said, "Sir, I want you to build me a new home. I don't have time to bother with it myself. I'm turning my trust and all over to you. You make all the decisions. I trust you, sir. You trusted a man he just met that he doesn't even know. If you do a good job," the wealthy man says, "I promise to pay you well." So look at that now. This man has got a blessing, a stranger that came to put a check for $300,000 in his hand, told him to build a home. He don't have time to be fooling with it right now. He says, "You have it. I trust you." When I was trusting in that man, now that man should have knew right then that was Jesus. He says, the builder, the architect, he got excited. Oh, that $300,000 check, boy, it's going down. He can finally start making him some money. Mind you now, he got the $300,000 check to build his home, and he's going to get paid very well. But he got to thank him. You go to the devil now. If I cut a few corners here and there, maybe I could pocket some of this $300,000. Oh, how does that sound? Have we heard that before? Huh? If I use this for a reason, this girl here sure don't know. I'm still going to be cute. Still blind. You already know I'm lying. My God. So he went out and bought the cheapest concrete he could find. He paid $4,000 or $5,000 there with that concrete. In his pocket. Hey! He had the cement mixer to water down the concrete. Huh? He said, he said he went out and bought the cheapest concrete he could find. He had the cement mixer to water it down so it would stretch further. He said $4,000 or $5,000 on that. He got excited. He went out and found the cheapest wood, lumber he could find. Mm-hmm. Some of the wood he bought was bent, warped, cooking, molding, detail. He was saving him some money. It was going to be hidden behind closed walls anyway. How many of us got stuck in the closet? This man ain't gonna put a leg down or arm out that closet. Y'all thinking, ain't nobody gonna do that. And then all of a sudden, your lady comes falling all that closet. All skeletons came out. See, you can't hide under the dog. God said, "What's in the dog shall what?" No, this says he speaks what? Truth. Amen. So he went out, and that's that he wanted the cheapest concrete, the cheapest wood, and all this while they're excited. He was excited, he went out and found the cheapest number he could find. So it was bent, warped, crooked, and molded. He didn't care. It was going to be hidden behind the wall. Nobody would ever see it. He did the same thing with the plumbing and the electricity. How come around here don't have any lights? We don't get it all, and still stealing. We don't all get it. See, everything around here, people try to do and try to get over, but it's stealing, still. It's still stealing. That's not what faithful servants do. And I can admit, I used to deal with those people. Thank you, Lord.
Yeah. It was God who
did it. You did the same thing with the plumbing and electrical work and so on. Cut corners and save the money. When the house was completed, now the house is done. That man saved him $40,000 that he went and banked secretly without the man even knowing. Built the house beautiful. He deposited in his own bank account. So he called his wealthy friend, the architect called the man, to come over and take a look at the house. So now the purchaser came over and he was quite impressed. Looked nice, went there, looked good. See, things from the outside look good, but be rotten on the inside. See, that's how a lot of church folks is. Be all holy at the church, but you can get home and crush like a fail.
That's it, now. Now you're talking.
But you call yourself a faithful servant. I'm calling you no faithful servant, you're a hypocrite.
That's it.
Amen. So, the home looking beautiful. He never guessed that the builder had cut corners, compromising the integrity of the whole house. Amen? The builder was ecstatic with his work. He noted a pleased expression on the owner's face. He couldn't wait to see how much he was going to get. So now the builder all said, please, please, he has it. Like, boy, he likes it, he's impressed. I'm going to get paid. My DOM stole $40,000 from the man. But he's going to get paid. Didn't notice that Jesus in the making. This is his own blessings up. So he couldn't wait to see how much he was going to get paid. After all, he knew the owner was a very generous man. As the wealthy man walked to the front door, he turned and twinkled in his eye and said to the builder, you know, I don't really need this house. I already got a beautiful home. I was just trying to help you out. And you were faithful. He handed the builder the keys and said, here you are, my friend. This is for you. You just built yourself a house. See, we get blessed and don't even know when we get blessed because we got a greedy heart.
That's it.
You understand me? A heart full of greed. We're not faithful servants because our motives are in the wrong place.
That's it. Your motives.
You understand me? That's our motives are in the wrong place. If you have the spiritual eyes and the spiritual ears and know that God's Holy Spirit gives you, you would have knew that was Jesus coming to help you.
Cheating people here and not paying taxes over there, compromising right and left.
And we ain't just compromising by the Lord. I'm going to give you a death by compromising. A lot of times we do things, we come back, well, God just bless me. No, anywhere God don't bless your situation right there. Let me give you an example. I went to the store, and I didn't know no better because I had just been in church about a month. And I go to the Ching Chong Hair Store, go get me some lashes, right? So I go in there, and I got $20 bill, and the lady gave me about $25. God, I'm telling you, look, God, God, to bless the girl.
Now you know God don't even play no mess like that.
But yeah, I ain't know nothing. I'm telling the truth. I'm not speaking about me. I said, God, God, bless me. And my daughter come out. She's right there. She come out. What happened? I said, girl, I got me a free ass and $5 extra. I said, God, bless me. God didn't bless me. That was stealing because I knew that wasn't my money. I said, if I hadn't played with it then like I got now, I should have took my butt back in that stove and would have told them people, you made a mistake. But we always say it's a blessing. Or how many of us be in the store and you see somebody in front of you and drop the $50 bill and we do that foot slide?
Yeah.
No, I'm not lying. No, that man dropped that money.
Yeah.
Even if you didn't see it, and you know it wasn't yours, but you do that foot slide.
Yeah.
You can't do that. That's not integrity, amen? God doesn't approve of those types of things. So in other words, what I'm saying is, are you a faithful servant? Are you an honorable person? Are you going to let the world build, tear down your foundation? Amen? Look at your name and say, are you a faithful servant? And that will be it for our authority today. Father God, I thank you, Lord, for allowing me to speak word of truth to y'all today. Amen. I hope y'all enjoyed it. Amen. God is